Hello, welcome back. This is stage one. I'm your host for the day, Alan Kanaba from APIable.io. So I'm going to be with you for the rest of the day, and this section here is about banking. And I'm joined now by Joonas. Hi, Joonas.
Hello. How are you? Sorry, I was having problem with audio. Of course, I was looking at the main stage before we was having this and
right, it
was
right.
All right, yeah.
No worries. We made it. We have these teething troubles with these virtual conferences, but we get there bit by bit. So I noticed you're at home there. So your opening question then is, do you drink more or less coffee when you're at home in compared to the office?
Yeah, that's a good question because, yeah, as you maybe know, I'm drinking a lot of coffee. And right now, because we have a Chemex coffee maker in office, it's taking some time to make. So it's probably so that I'm drinking less in the office
than
home, because in home, I have always coffee on coffee machine.
Okay. I think the first thing my wife did during the coronavirus is she ordered a very expensive coffee machine. It's just like, okay, look, we need coffee. So
yeah, that's a smart move.
Exactly. All righty, Joonas. So I'm going to leave you to it. Then you're talking about PSD2, APIs, and the future of open banking. So yeah, I'll speak to you in a little while.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. And in this presentation, my idea is first, start with a small thing with our company, then go to the whole world, and then back to the Europe, and then go to the small things back. So I try to cover quite a lot in this 25 minutes, but I try to focus so that you are getting something out of this 25 minutes also. So yeah, my name is Joonas Tomperi, and I'm a CEO of Enable Banking. We have been established in 2019, early 2019, and we are providing a software developer kit, which is making the connections to banks' PSD2 APIs. And this topic is really close to my heart, so be kind if I'm going too deep. And yeah. So a little bit about our company. So we are really like focusing the PSD2. We are making sure that our customers are able to use these PSD2 APIs. And we are looking always partners. We have one public reference partner called Crosskey, and they are offering this kind of amazing solutions of top of open banking, and also they are providing some of open banking APIs for banks, and they are good with that one also. And then my presentation is just a couple of web pages. I will send you all the links. And in this web page, our main page, one thing what I want to show is that if you are really interested in this topic and you want to start to try, you can just start quickly, choose one sandbox connector, which bank you want, and then download our SDK and start playing around with that one. So yeah, the PSD2 itself, it's the it's the regulation from European Bank Association, and it's making so that banks have to open the APIs for other company usage, and it's a regulation, so it means that it's also regulated who is able to get a connection with these APIs. They are called TPPs. Third-party providers, and what you can do with these PSD2 APIs, you can get account information from normal accounts and credit accounts, and you can make payment initiations. And for this one, for account information, there is a particular account information service provider. And for payment initiation, there is payment initiation service provider. And these are regulated roles. And then also one thing what is really important in this case is that there is also the strong customer authentication related to usage of these APIs. So every time when a customer is going and they want to provide you access to the account information, they need to authenticate with their own bank credentials and also give you consent to get the data. And the consent is normally valid 90 days. So yeah, this is basically like what is PSD2. Next thing what I want to show you is one place where you can find the players in this field. So if you are thinking that you want to come in this field and you are looking that maybe I want to do something with account information and I want to register my company for this one, this EPA payment institution register is good place to check what kind of companies there is and what kind of licenses and registrations they have. And as you see, our company is also registered here. So we are under the Finnish Financial Supervisor Authority, called FinFSA. Friendly name for them. But yeah. Then, little bit like widening the thing what I want to tell you is that many times when we are talking about the open banking, we in Europe, we are mixing the PSD2 and open banking. Why is that? Because PSD2 is one driver which is driving really like with the force open banking in Europe. But open banking itself, it's more. And as you see, this is from Accenture old survey. But I think this is showing quite nicely that there is many this kind of project in globally. And they have really like different items what you can get from the APIs. And from my point of view, one place to check how this ecosystem is evolving is to check what other areas are doing in this open banking area. So I will share also this one with you guys so you can check yourself. An example for this one is example Australia, and they have put a laws for this one, Consumer Data Rights Act, and this is pushing also the Australian banks to share data with other companies in that area. And this FinExtra is also one good place to follow this whole ecosystem, what is happening, who is acquiring who, because this is something what is happening a lot in this this area. And yeah, I think this is one of the places where it's easy to follow what is happening. Then I'm jumping back to the Europe. I'm using one competitor page because they have been doing great work with the studies. And I'm sharing also this page for you, but these are like Q2 numbers of the regulated players. And as you see, the total number of regulated players, it's not so high. It's under 400 in Q2. Of course, this is growing 29% every Q. So it means that this is really like raising, the number is raising really fast. But still, this is in the starting point. And when we are discussing about the future of open banking, the next steps are that we are really starting to use these PSD2 APIs. And we are starting to really make things top of these. I know that in Finland there is a couple good examples of this, like maybe Enfuse and Asiakastieto is one, that they are together making better data with this one for the companies. But in overall, this is still in the starting point. And why I want to say this is that if you have idea for how to use this data, now it's the time to jump in and start to make things happen, because you are not yet late. That's a good thing. There is many our kind of players who are providing access to these APIs, so you don't need to make every API connection by yourself, and you are able to build your business case quite easily in this area, and you are still able to be first ones in this field in many cases. So I would really say that now it's time to look this whole thing and really like look own business models and own data what you already have, and think that if I'm enriching this data with the account information, is this good business? And also if you are thinking that is there some payments what would be maybe good to make with this new technology, now it's the time to start to look. And then I want to show also really good slide. This is from Open Banking Europe, Greta from Greta, who have the Open Banking Europe page. And this is the one slider where you are able to find most of the relevant directives and documentation about getting access to this market if you are looking the license or registration for your company. And I have to say that right now it's also possible to start without the license or registration if you have partner who are able to provide you the services. Some cases it's not possible, but many cases you can also get the fast start in this area. And as you see, the European Parliament is the highest level, then there is the European Commission, then there is the European Bank Association and the European Central Bank. And under that, there is these national parliaments, and they have these own FSAs, as example, the FinFSA, Finanssivalvonta. And then there, in this environment, there is also a lot of these standards, which are trying to make so that the APIs are more easy to use for the companies. And right now, the most important standards, I think so, more or less in Europe, is the Berlin Group and the Open Banking UK. Open Banking UK, because it has been around a little bit longer, so it's a little bit more mature. Many companies or banks are also using that one. And Berlin Group have been making a really good work to expand in Europe. Also, state is relevant. And then there is also these some of the local players like Poland own standard and this. So yeah. And under these are us, the service providers and payment service providers, and then the users. And this is a really good starting point for looking data. Then next, I was first thinking to show this with the notepad, but have to say that JSON is not the easiest to read, but this is the real data what you are getting from PSD2 API. So if we are looking here, of course, I'm a little bit mixed this data, that it's not so accurate. But if you are looking here, you are seeing that you are getting the currency, you are getting the dates, and you are getting maybe some kind of description of this. And then hopefully you are getting the counterparty name and payment days and also the amounts. But if you look this data, you are really understanding that this is really similar what you are seeing in web bank when you are a consumer. So So this is the data what is really like a starting point. And many business cases, you need to have some extra data with this one that you are making really good business case. And one example here is that because this is our company data, there is this kind of transaction which is really like not telling what it is. And when we are diving a little bit more inside this kind of transaction, this is a screenshot from our accounting solution. You are seeing that in same transaction, we have many payments, and you are not seeing this from the data, what you are getting from bank. And this is the reason why I say that you need to, many cases, have the data to enrich this data or enrich some data with this one to make really good business case. But in overall, this data is in quite good shape, and I have background with RPA projects and this kind of stuff, and have to say that normally the cleaning is taking 90% of time in a project, and with this data, maybe you are getting under 50% of time and spending with the data. So this is quite good data in my eyes. Okay, and now we have been a little bit touching everything I have to say, and one part of my presentation was also a little bit think about the future. And from my point of view, the future is that this is a really like a starting point for really nice new journey in this ecosystem. And we are seeing more and more how banks are providing more APIs because they have been spending so much money with the platforms to deliver these APIs where they don't really have so much business case. And they are looking the new business cases with new APIs to provide better services to their customer and get some revenue. And this is just because we have OP presenting today later on. I was choosing OP, and of course they are one forerunner in the Finnish environment, banking environment. And you are seeing already from the developer portal that they have been starting to build the new APIs and new business cases, wealth management APIs, and you know, many, many different things. And this is where I see that this journey is going. But the first step is that we need to start to build business cases top of these APIs, what we have, and get transactions there and get payments going. Because I think in this area, the payments are one driver, big driver in to get these APIs in really good level. And also that there is no downtimes and this kind of stuff in this environment. And in the end of our presentation, I want to show, we was launching this service yesterday called Tilisu. And this is the service where you are able to fetch your own bank data from different banks. Now we are first supporting the Finnish banks and get that in a JSON file or CS file. And you can start to play with the data and you can really look what you are getting from these accounts and understand that one. And yeah. So, and in the end, I will share you these links and in the chat, and also we have this kind of coupon for the Tilisu, so you are able to test and see the data by yourself with this coupon for free. So here is the links. Hopefully it's not too messy. or maybe I have to cut that one and send it later on. But okay, so that is all. And yeah, I think, hopefully you was getting something from this presentation and some thoughts about the whole environment.
Hey, very, very good, Joonas. I like the fact that you put so much detail in there that, I think when we get access to the presentation as well, we can, follow up on a lot of that. And, well, I know what I'm doing tomorrow then. Tilisi.
It's an English version of Tilisi. Tilisi means your account in Finnish. So
all right, there you go.
It's just English version with I in the end.
got it. Yeah, it works for me. Yeah, that's quite interesting. Well, I'll definitely give that a go, right? Because I have an OP account as well, so I can I can quickly do a demo. And that'll be interesting to see what I get out of that. A couple of questions for you. You're talking about it's important to start with these SDKs and the data you get and work on business models, business cases on top of that. As a personal passion of mine is the whole API as a product paradigm. So do you see anybody kind of like using that paradigm to deliver that business value?
Good question. And we are seeing, as I said, the end user and asiakastieto is one good example of that. They are really like making good work to enrich the data with this data source, and they are able to really make the business case top of this one. So I think they are doing good work, and we are seeing many companies starting to pull this kind of thing. This whole environment is interesting in that reason that the starting point, it's looking that the starting point is that there is coming companies who are providing the API platforms top of these APIs.
Right.
Then we are seeing that some cases we are really seeing the end customer business cases and this. But this is in the starting point already. And if you want to look this one, I think you should go back to the UK, and look what they are doing there, because they are a little bit for a runner in this area. They
have okay.
been live, more than other parts of Europe.
Right. For me, it feels a little bit like, any of these, regulations, PSD2, you're told what to expose, right? This is the API. It's very, this data is the payment information, right? Whereas what we're trying to do more in the API world is to flip that on its head to say, okay, before you start talking about, okay, APIs, you start talking about like a value proposition. Who's going to use this thing? Why are they going to use it? And okay, it's given, but, taking it to the next level, saying, okay, like you said, you've got the infrastructure there, you built it for PSD2, where next, right? And that's kind of like what you're saying as well, right? In having these business cases and starting here, but thinking about where to move to, right?
And I have to say that the easiest business cases here is the lending. It's one of the lending companies are getting your account information and then they are able to provide faster service to the people who is trying to get the loan. So this kind of stuff, it's a really easy business case and it's growing fast.
Hey, I missed a couple of questions that popped up in the chat, but we can maybe grab one of them quickly. Do you see companies allowing access to their bank accounts, or is it more about consumer customers?
This is good question, and I love this part of this whole thing, because I think the B2B side in here, in that sense, this is my opinion, that's the place where we are really seeing the benefits with the account information. So because you can example build quite good fancy solution for matching the account information with your accounting with this data. And there is a really like good opportunities. And if you are interested about that one, please connect, because this is one of my favorite topics to speak. So
good question. There's one more question in the chat. Joonas, if you can answer it in the chat, because I think we're out of time here and we need to move on. But hey, great presentation. Thank you very much. And so long.
Yeah. See ya.